Hi, I'm Heather. I'm one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. In this video, we're going to talk about sensor states. I'm going to go over the various different states a sensor can have and what those states mean. So let's go take a look. All right, let's take a look at the sensor states. If you go to the upper right-hand corner of your browser, you're going to see that they are all color-coded. We have red, pink, yellow, green, blue, orange, and gray. So the green one is good, it's up. There's nothing really more to say about that because then that's when you're in your best sensor state. Next, I'm going to talk about the red and the yellow. Red is down and yellow is warning. So by default, when a sensor does not respond the first time, it will go into a warning state. And then if it doesn't respond for two times or two state scanning or polling intervals, it will go into the down state. We do that because if it's a false alarm, there was a blip, it didn't connect, and then it comes back up, then it will go from warning to good. But then if it's multiple times, it will go to down. You can actually change this behavior if you go into the settings tab, and then we go down to scanning intervals, right here. And this is where you change your scanning interval if you want it from 5 minutes or 1 minute, 60 seconds, 30 seconds, but that's not what we're going to talk about right now. This is the setting that I want to point out to you if a sensor query fails. Because here, by default, that recommend the setting that I told you about, that after one, it's going to go to warning and then to down. But here you can have 2, 3, 4, 5 intervals for warning before it goes to down. And you can change that in the device tree for root, probe. You can do device sensor setting for that. All right, let's go back to the main device tree now. So the other thing is with a down sensor, you could set a down sensor to acknowledge. So for example here, I'm going to just pick one of my red sensors. We'll go to this ping sensor. If you want to set this to acknowledge, you could come down here and you could say acknowledge alarm, and you could do it indefinitely or for a set period of time. That's one way to do it. You can also do this by right-clicking on the sensor. So if we come in here, let me find a sensor that is down. I can right click here and you could say I can acknowledge the alarm as well. If you're using the PRTG mobile app, you can acknowledge an alarm also. Down is the only sensor state that you can acknowledge. All right, so then if you do go ahead and acknowledge that alarm, that's where you get the ping state, which is downed acknowledge. So that's saying that the sensor, it's still down, but it's acknowledged, so therefore it will stop sending your notifications out. But it still will poll at its regular polling interval, and eventually once the condition changes, then the sensor will go into the upstate again. All right, I just want to double check and make sure I told you everything that I want to tell you about that before we move on. All right, so the next sensor state is going to be the blue, which is the paused. You pause the sensor by right-clicking on it, and then you can, well, this one is already paused, so that's how you would resume one. But if I do want to pause a sensor, I right-click here, and then I can go to pause, and then set your period of time indefinitely, 5, 15, 1 hour. You'll also find pause sensors, say you have, if a parent device goes down, and because you have the hierarchy, then the child ones will pause if the parent's down because of the way you might have the dependency structure on it. A pause sensor does not poll. It won't change sensor states until it's resumed, where downed acknowledge still does continue to poll. So that's important for you to understand that. All right, gray sensors, they're unknown. Sensors are unknown for a few reasons. When you first set up a sensor and it hasn't polled yet, it might be unknown. Also, if it's no communication, so if you don't have your credentials set up right, it's not communicating, the PRTG can't talk to your device for that sensor, it might be unknown as well. We do have a KB article on our website that can go over how to handle gray or unknown sensors. All right, then unusual, the orange sensors. So this sensor is different because the other sensors go based upon the polling interval, and that will, you know, give you information based upon the state of the sensor, as far as if it's up, down, warning, that type of thing, and based upon sensor limits, which I'm going to be discussing sensor limits in another video. But for unusual, PRTG gets to know patterns of behavior, usually takes about 1 or 2 weeks, and then creates a baseline. If something is outside that normal pattern, it becomes unusual. So it's atypical for a specific time of day of the week. The way we set unusual monitoring, if you go into setup and into monitoring, you're going to see unusual detection. And you can completely turn this off if you don't want unusual, but then we're going to have our out of the box settings, or you can change it, and it's based upon averaging. So you could do it based upon a 24-hour average, or you could do an hourly average, and you can see how you could change the percentiles here, and then you can choose to have the logging on or off or not. So to give you a better idea, let's take a look at a few examples of the unusual sensor states, and then you might understand what I mean a little bit clearer. So for this one, it's unusual because the 1 hour interval average is unusually low for this hour of the week. Now you'll notice, even though it's in the orange state, it's still up. So this doesn't affect if a sensor is up or down. It's just that the data is not in the norm for it. I always like to say a good example is if you see spikes in bandwidth at 3 a.m. on Saturday when normally there is very little traffic going through, it may mark it as unusual and let you know that something might be going on that you want to take a look at. So that is the unusual state. There is a partial down state. I don't have it up here. That is for a cluster because each half of a cluster does poll independently. So if one half of a cluster polls and it's up, the other half of the cluster polls and it's down, it can do a partial down because it has conflicting information as well. So let's see. So we have this here, and if you click each of these colors, it's going to bring up a list of sensors of that status. Another way you can do that is from the sensor menu too. We come up here and you can do sensors, you could do by current status, and then you can go through the list as well to group the sensors by a particular status as well. So this is our tutorial based upon the sensor states. I hope you found this helpful. Please take a look at our website for other videos that we have on PRTG. If you have any questions, contact us at support@pestler.com. Thank you very much. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pestler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.